Assistant Union Minister holding Ministries of Electronics and Information Technology and Law and Justice in Government of India. As a student leader, he campaigned vigorously for restoration of freedom of press and that of individuals during the national emergency in 1975, which brought him to the forefront of the Indian political landscape. He is a member of the parliament since 2000, and as a minister in government led by Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he was instrumental in bringing DTH services to television broadcasting in India. He liberalized FM radio services and granted industry status to the Indian cinema. Since his appointment as the cabinet minister for the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology in 2014, he has been spearheading the implementation of flagship program of the Government of India, the Digital India, and has also been championing the cause of free and open internet, which is easily accessible to all, even in the face of pressure from all-powerful multinationals. His latest initiative is 2019 Smart India Hackathon, which I'm sure many of you might be participating in, aimed at finding solutions to more than 500 software and hardware problems of the industry. We are certain that this initiative of his will build bridges between industry and the academia like never before, and will mark the beginning of a new chapter in collaboration between these two major stakeholders in the economic development of the country. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my private proud privilege to now request the very dynamic and enthusiastic chief guest of the day, Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad ji, Honorable Union Minister, for his much awaited address.
Mr. Ashok Mittal, Chancellor of the LPU, my good friend, President of the State BJP, Member of Parliament, Shweta Malik, Som Prakash ji, Dr. Manoj Chakravarti, Nisha Mendiratta, P.P. Mathur, Professor Gangadhar, Ashwini Kumar, delegates of the Indian Science Congress, and my young friends of the LPU University. Kaise ho? Tumhari university ka naam bahut suna tha. Aaj aakar bahut achha laga. It is a good campus. And Mr. Mittal, my compliments to you. It's really a very good campus. I'm deeply impressed, and 40,000 students are studying here. It's a matter of great pride. Keep it up. Friends, what is the theme of Indian Science Congress? Future India, science and technology. And what is the theme of this interaction where I'm going to speak to you? Communicating science. This is the age of technology. Technology is power. This is the age of information. Information is power. And this is the age of communication. Communication is power. Remember these three things at the very outset. Sitting here in Jalandhar, at a click of your mobile, you can know what is happening in Latin America. You can give your views on social media. Aaj ki duniya bahut choti ho gayi hai. Technology has enabled a virtual world which is not limited by geography or boundaries of a country. There is a digital world. You get news on the line. You get news on the television. You get news on the social media. And then the YouTube, where you can scan and get everything. Do you know in Hindustan how many TV channels are in Akash? 650. And do you know in Hindustan how many news channels are? 245, 24/7, in Hindi, English, Telugu, Tamil, Punjabi. Many of them is speaking sense, some is speaking nonsense too, which you may be knowing. अब देखो मैं यहाँ बोल रहा हूँ, कितने लोग मोबाइल से मेरा भाषण रिकॉर्ड कर रहे हैं, दैट दे आर राइट. द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिजिटल वर्ल्ड एंड द फिजिकल वर्ल्ड इज नाउ कंप्लीटली इरोडिंग, वैनिश्ड. हाउ डू वी चैनलाइज दिस पावर ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर ह्यूमन गुड इज द लार्जर क्वेश्चन. एंड फ्रॉम देयर बिगैन द पावर ऑफ डिजिटल इंडिया. How leaders communicate about science is very important. Lal Bahadur Shastri said, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. A very great, honest Prime Minister. Atal Bihari Vajpayee added, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Vigyan. And dynamic Narendra Modi ji added here, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Vigyan, Jai Anusandhan. Research. When leaders lead from the front, then the country has a different perspective altogether. And Modi ji is a great lover of technology. He went on technology in 90s when he was not even the chief minister. When he was campaigning to become the Prime Minister of India in 2014 election, he coined a phrase, if I come to power, I will make an India where IT plus IT is equal to IT. What does it mean? India's talent IT plus information technology IT is equal to India tomorrow IT is what I will create. I will make few presentations after I conclude my initial remarks. Digital India has emerged from there. Remember, Indian IT companies have done very well globally. I met Pratham, the son of Ashok Mittal, who has also become a software engineer and doing a good job. Good. Today, Indian IT companies have scaled our tricolor in 200 cities of 80 countries. Revenue $168 billion. Export $125 billion. We are proud of that. But digital India is beyond. Digital India is designed to transform India with the power of technology, to empower ordinary Indians with the power of technology, to bridge the digital divide between digital haves and digital have-nots. And lastly, to bring in digital inclusion, Samaveshi Digital Bharat. जहां आम आदमी के हाथ में भी टेक्नोलॉजी की ताकत हो. और दिस मस्ट हैपन थ्रू टेक्नोलॉजी विच इज लो कॉस्ट, इंडिया क्रिएटेड एंड ऑल्सो इंक्लूसिव. दैट इज डिजिटल इंडिया. आज आपके सामने मैं कुछ प्रेजेंटेशन दूंगा. मैं चाहता हूं कि ये चीजें आपके दिमाग में आए कि डिजिटल इंडिया में हमने क्या किया है. And I would urge the members of the Indian Science Congress present here to further communicate in their own way as to how a transformation is happening in India. मेरे दोस्तों, अभी किसी ने बताया कि गरीब आदमी के हाथ में मोबाइल है. अभी वो हम संख्या बताएंगे. हिंदुस्तान कैसे बदल रहा है इसका मैं एक उदाहरण देना चाहता हूं. और ऐसे उदाहरण आप और खोजिए. एक दिन मैं एज एन आईटी मिनिस्टर बैठता हूं दिल्ली के स्कोप कॉम्प्लेक्स में और एज ए लॉ मिनिस्टर बैठता हूं शास्त्री भवन में. तो मैं आईटी मिनिस्ट्री से शास्त्री भवन जा रहा था. बीच में एक बड़ा रेड लाइट है तो मेरी गाड़ी भी रुक गई. नरेंद्र मोदी के मंत्रियों की गाड़ी रेड लाइट पर रुकती है, उसको तोड़ती नहीं है, ध्यान रखा करो. तो बगल में एक रिक्शा ठेला वाला वो भी खड़ा था. मैं रिक्शा में उतर के इसकी फोटो खींचूं अपने मोबाइल पर. वो दो स्मार्टफोन लिए हुए था. एक स्मार्टफोन से वो कह रहा था मैंने आपका माल पहुंचा दिया, आप निश्चिंत हो जाइए. और दूसरे को कह रहा था आधा घंटा और लगेगा, आपका माल भी पहुंचा दूंगा. नाउ रिमेंबर, नो वन टोल्ड दैट रिक्शा वाला, बट ही रियलाइज if I have to be in business, I must have the power of technology, of mobile phone, of internet. That is the new India which the digital India is creating. And today, I am just going to briefly tell you a few slides. I hope all of you can see the slides now. Huh?
They are visible here also, sir, on the screens.
Okay. Actually, I'll keep on explaining it. And see the power of technology. My private secretary of the Indian Foreign Service, okay? But he's equally well versed in technology, because now people of the Foreign Service also know that if they have to communicate well globally, they must be good in technology. Therefore, I would come from the start. Yes. Now see this first slide. Digital India is what? Digital technology to transform the lives of the people. And see right-hand side, what is the digital profile of India? 123 crore Aadhaar, number one. 121 crore mobile phones. 44.6 crore smartphones. 56 crore internet users. 51% growth in e-commerce. 29 crore Facebook users. दोस्तों एक बात याद रखो, हिंदुस्तान की आबादी 130 करोड़, मोबाइल फोन 121 करोड़। और नरेंद्र मोदी की 4.5 साल सरकार में हमने इस देश में इतना मोबाइल फोन ऐड किया है जितना फ्रांस और इटली की जनसंख्या है। आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट। आधार 123 करोड़, आधार के बारे में आगे मैं बताऊंगा। नेक्स्ट, यू चेंज इट अंशुमान, नेक्स्ट। यस यस नेक्स्ट यस। अब आप देखें मोबाइल कनेक्टिविटी, अभी कोई चल, लोएस्ट कॉस्ट ऑफ मोबाइल इंटरनेट अवेलेबल इन इंडिया, यह हमारी नीति रही है। We have given competition that India has the lowest mobile connectivity. And mobile data consumption grew by 1680%. आजकल आप लोग कहते हो ना, कुछ भी चाहिए तो Google गुरु के पास चलते हैं. You get all the details there. You surf on the internet. You talk to your friends. You see the video, all the new developments. That is how Indians are developing a passion for data use. And 5G we are going to roll also by 2020. Next. ये भारत नेट क्या है? देश के 2.5 लाख ग्राम पंचायत को हम ऑप्टिकल फाइबर से जोड़ रहे हैं, ऑप्टिकल फाइबर। And my young friends, I want only to tell you one data. This was known as NOFN, National Optical Fiber Network. Began in 2011. In 2011, now it is known as BharatNet. In 2011 to 2014, 3 years, how many kilometers of optical fiber laid down? 358 kilometers. In 4 years, how many kilometers we have laid down? 3 lakh kilometers.
Oh God.
You understand? The same government, the same officers, the same engineers, but if the mission is there, how you can change the dynamics? Now more than 1 lakh gram panchayats are optically fiber connected. The rest will be completed 2.5 lakh by this year end. Next. Now come to Aadhaar. What is Aadhaar? I would like to show my Aadhaar for a moment. See, this is my Aadhaar. You all have Aadhaar. What does it contain? My photograph. I am a male, the name of my father, and my permanent Patna address. What it does not contain? My caste, my community, my religion, my medical record, my income, or my sexual preferences, by which I can be trolled. But the system contains my fingerprint and my iris. Aadhaar is the digital identity to supplement the physical identity. How it works? You will see the next item is Jam Trinity, Anshuman? Yes. See, we opened 33 crore bank account of the poor. We linked that with mobile phone and with Aadhaar. We started sending welfare measures directly to the bank account of the poor. Gas subsidy, kerosene subsidy, ration subsidy, Manrega payment. The digital identity confirms the physical identity. How it works? You go to a bank, he shows your Aadhaar card, the number, he talks to the system says, this number is of Ravi Shankar Prasad. And the system confirms 1 crore Aadhaar in every 3 minutes. And Aadhaar is a low-cost technology. 82 rupees per Aadhaar. Kept in safe and secure condition in India, in two places of Bangalore and Manesar. And do you know how much we have saved? 90,000 crores. कैसे सेव किया? हिंदुस्तान में क्या होता था? बेटी पैदा हुई नहीं, बेटी बड़ी हो गई, उसकी शादी भी हो गई, वो विधवा भी हो गई और विधवा पेंशन मिलता था, ये होता था। बिहार, यूपी, एमपी, पंजाब, हरियाणा, मनरेगा पेमेंट, जिस गांव में एक भी विलेज मजदूर नहीं है उसमें सबसे अधिक मनरेगा पेमेंट। क्यों? मुखिया जी के रजिस्टर पर होता था सब। अब सब खत्म। The money goes to your bank account. Digital governance is good governance. Digital delivery is faster delivery. That's how we are changing the narrative of India. And the poor people are getting empowered. इसलिए और एक बात जान लो, Aadhaar is completely safe and secure. Backed by a parliamentary law. And it is so tough that even if I disclose my identity for unauthorized purposes, as an IT and law minister, I can be prosecuted. Companies can be prosecuted. Pure world ne, IMF ne, World Bank ne, Aadhaar ki bahut tarif ki hai, ki India has come with a great new initiative of transforming the life of common people. So this Aadhaar, you need to understand, DBT, direct benefit transfer, is a great game changer of empowering the poor people of India. अब अभी हम एक और लॉ में परिवर्तन करने जा रहे हैं, पेंडिंग है पार्लियामेंट में, मोटर व्हीकल लाइसेंस को Aadhaar से लिंक करेंगे। क्यों? शराब पी के गाड़ी चला रहे थे, एक्सीडेंट कर दिया, 4 लोग मर गए, पंजाब से भाग करके बिहार चले गए, यूपी चले गए, डुप्लीकेट लाइसेंस बनवा लिया। यू कैन चेंज योर नेम but you cannot change your biometrics, the iris or the fingerprint. The moment you will go for a duplicate license, the system will say, this gentleman is already having a motor vehicle license, should not be given to him. This is how we are changing the quality of life of India. Next, e-scholarship. Today, 2 crore Indians are on the portal of e-scholarship. 5,000 crore payment of scholarship have been meant linked with Aadhaar. The middlemen, the fictitious claimants, all have been eliminated. Pensioners, 2.38 crores, Atal Pension Yojana, Jeevan Suraksha Yojana, all have been paid linked to Aadhaar. Next. This e-hospital, what is the e-hospital? I was just telling Mr. Mittal, my party president, Mr. Ashwani Kumar, I come from Bihar. People used to come to AIMS. पहले दिल्ली आओ, अपने को रजिस्टर कराओ, फिर आपको डेट मिलती थी। I told my system, find a way out for it. Then we came e-appointment. Today, by logging in with the AIMS website, you can register yourself. You will get a date, इस तारीख को ये डॉक्टर आपका इंतजार करेंगे. That is how technology is facilitating. Transfer of your pathological requirement. Today, I am very happy to 321 hospitals are e-hospitals all over the country, and 4 crore patients have been registered and got benefit. This is called digital delivery of services, how we are making life e-scholarship, e-hospital, direct benefit transfer. Next. This is what? Soil health card. 17 crore cards have been given to farmers. आपकी तबीयत खराब होती है तो आप एक्सरे कराते हो, बाकी करते हो. आपकी मिट्टी की तबीयत कैसे, कभी देखा है? सॉइल हेल्थ कार्ड गिव्स यू अप टू डेट. इज योर सॉइल ओवर फर्टिलाइज्ड? डू यू नीड टू चेंज योर क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न? द SMS इज गिवन इन लोकल लैंग्वेजेस ऑल ओवर द कंट्री. द फार्मर हु गेट्स रजिस्टर्ड, दैट इज ऑल अ पार्ट ऑफ डिजिटल इंडिया. नेक्स्ट, ई नैम. किसानों को अपनी मंडी में सामान बेचना है, कहां कहां जाए. ई नैम इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर 1.27 करोड़ फार्मर्स आर लिंक टू 585 मंडीज. यू टॉक टू द मंडी, निगोशिएट योर प्राइस एंड डिलीवर योर क्रॉप्स. दैट इज हाउ इवन फार्मर्स ट्रेडिंग इज बीइंग फैसिलिटेटेड बाय डिजिटल इंडिया. नेक्स्ट, डिजिटल लॉकर. ये बताओ तो डिजिटल लॉकर का यूज करते हो? हाथ उठाओ तो. ओ आई एम सो हैप्पी टू हियर द IT मिनिस्टर क्लैप्स द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ LPU फॉर बीइंग टेक्नोलॉजी सेवी. कीप इट अप. रजिस्टर्ड यूजर 1.72 करोड़. डॉक्यूमेंट लोडेड 2.28 करोड़. इश्यूड डॉक्यूमेंट 3.47 करोड़. डिजिटल लॉकर इज फ्री. आधार इज $1 लेस. आई टोल्ड यू 80 रुपीज प्लस. How we are changing India by application of technology and empowering the common people. Next, e-marketplace gem. About 158,082 seller and services are provided. They are the PSUs and the state PSUs. अब सरकार को कुर्सी खरीदनी है, क्या करें? डस्टबिन खरीदना है. All the companies go and apply here. The government will negotiate, no formal tender. And friends, do you know, government of India has saved 37 crore only in purchase of dustbin in the last 1 year because of application of this. Because everyone goes and applies there. No L1 or L2 negotiation VC par hota hai, tere se maal nahi lunga, jao, sasta karo. How technology is changing the quality of life, I wanted to convey to you. Next. पार्टिसिपेटिंग गवर्नेंस. मन की बात में मोदी जी बात करते हैं. अभी आपने देखा होगा मोदी जी ने एक बहुत बड़ी बात की थी. मोदी जी मन की बात में कभी पॉलिटिक्स की बात नहीं करते. अभी उन्होंने एक, शायद वो पंजाब की थी या हरियाणा की थी, वो जूनियर बॉक्सिंग चैंपियन हुई है. उसके फादर दूध बेचते थे और पैसे काट के उसको सिखाया पढ़ाया. व्हेन शी वन द नेशनल चैंपियनशिप, व्हाट शी डिड, शी वेंट टू ए कॉर्नर शॉप का, मुझे एक गिलास दूध पिला दो. मेरे पिताजी ने दूध को काट करके मुझे सिखाया है, तो आज जब मैं नेशनल चैंपियन बनी हूं तो मुझे अपने पिता को सम्मान देना है दूध पीकर करके. यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? दिस एंड द PM पिक्स अप दोज स्टोरीज. मैं डिजिटल लिटरेसी की बात करूंगा तो आपको बताऊंगा हाउ वी आर इंकरेजिंग कॉमन पीपल ऑफ इंडिया. देन देर इज पार्टिसिपेटिव गवर्नेंस, वेर वी आस्क पीपल टू पार्टिसिपेट इन MyGov. It is a platform. You all should get joined. We went for crowdsourcing. Swachh Bharat. Iske liye hame aap design bana ke do. Wo Gandhi ji ke do chashme hai na, Swachh Bharat ke. That was created by crowdsourcing. This is how people of India are getting involved in the governance process. Next. Modi ji ne kaha ki governance logon ke haath mein honi chahiye. To humne Umang app banaya. 1200 government services are to be available on that. Today, more than 326 services are operational. 1 crore download is there. And what is this? You go to Umang app, click a button. I want detail of this government service, this state service, all will be available. Governance in the palm of ordinary Indians. That is a part of digital India. Next, digital literacy. हमें देश के 6 करोड़ गरीबों को डिजिटल लिटरेट बनाना है. अभी तक हम लगभग 1.7 करोड़ लोगों को 74 करोड़ लोगों को ट्रेन कर चुके हैं. वी गिव देम बेसिक लिटरेसी लाइक हाउ टू ऑपरेट ईमेल, हाउ टू ऑपरेट मोबाइल, हाउ टू गिव एन SMS, हाउ टू गेट गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज. एंड आपको बताऊं, मैं भी बता रहा था, एक है सतम्मा देवी ऑफ तेलंगाना, शी बिकेम डिजिटली लिटरेट. आई ट्वीटेड टू कंग्रेचुलेट हर, शी बिकेम ए सेलिब्रिटी. देन आई टॉक टू हर, शी डिड नॉट नो हिंदी और इंग्लिश. आई आस्क कि तुम कैसे बनी डिजिटली लिटरेट. शी सेड कि आई हैव ए ग्रैंडसन हू एंड माई सन इज ए प्लम्बर इन दुबई. आई वॉज मिसिंग माई ग्रैंडसन. देन द फ्रेंड सेड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टॉक टू योर ग्रैंडसन एंड ऑल्सो सी हिज फेस, लर्न टू ऑपरेट द स्काइप. And to operate the Skype, I became digitally literate. What is the age of that lady? 70 years. This is the emerging India you need to understand. There are countless other examples like this. I talked of Bajanti Devi, class 3 pass, she operates a CSE. She has become the brand ambassador of Swachh Bharat. I call these ladies to Delhi and I get their big, big photographs because they are creators of new India. And as a minister in charge of digital India, I stand behind them. Because the mission is, they must become the inspiration and role model for others. Next. CSC. It's a big movement. What is Common Service Center? Their digital khidki hai, digital delivery of service karte hai. Banking, insurance, land records, railway ticketing, passport banayenge aapke. इनकी संख्या 80,000 थी जब मेरी सरकार आई थी. नाउ देयर आर 3 लाख प्लस इंक्लूडिंग इन 2.10 लाख ग्राम पंचायत ऑफ इंडिया. मालूम है कितने बच्चे काम करते हैं? 12 लाख बच्चे काम करते हैं. हाउ मेनी वुमेन ऑफ एंटरप्रेन्योर? 60,000. मेनी ऑफ देम वर्क लाइक बैंक एंड आई एम वेरी प्राउड ऑफ देयर गुड वर्क दे आर डूइंग. रिमेंबर फ्रेंड्स, डिजिटल इंडिया टू सक्सीड हैज टू बिकम ए मास मूवमेंट. And the common service centers operations are like a part of that mass movement. Next, BPO in small towns. You know, there is a very emotional angle. I started this program. After becoming minister in the Modi government in 2014, I had gone to Bangalore to meet the top giants of the industry, like the Wipros, like the Infosys. Ek hotel mein meeting thi, main wahan se nikla. तो 300-400-500 बच्चे खड़े थे, बिहार, यूपी, एमपी, पंजाब, हरियाणा. टीवी के कारण सब चेहरा पहचानते. तो मिलने गया, कहा सर विल यू डू समथिंग, वी कैन रिटर्न टू आवर सिटीज एंड कस्बास, बेंगलुरु इज वेरी कॉस्टली. दिस स्ट्रक मी, आई केम विद आइडिया ऑफ बीपीओ इन स्मॉल टाउन्स ऑफ इंडिया. वी गिव सब्सिडी 1 लाख पर सीट. Friends, I started this program in 2015 and I am very happy to tell you that today 127 BPOs have started operating in different parts of India. Where? In places like Kohima, Nagaland, Imphal, Manipur, Guwahati, 5 BPO, Dibrugarh, Patna has 9 BPO, Katak, Bhubaneswar, Kashmir, Anantnag, Srinagar, गाजीपुर इन यूपी, बरेली, लखनऊ, बांदा, होस्ट ऑफ अदर प्लेसेस एंड मेनी, मोस्टली गर्ल्स आर वर्किंग इन दोज बीपीओ सेंटर्स. एंड द लेटेस्ट एंड इन पंजाब, पठानकोट, अमृतसर, मोहाली, ऑल दीज प्लेसेस दे हैव स्टार्टेड. आई एम गोइंग टू फर्दर द नॉर्थ ईस्ट, देयर इज अ सेपरेट बीपीओ स्कीम. एंड द लेटेस्ट प्रोग्राम विच आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वेरी सून इज घर बैठे बीपीओ का काम करो. वुमेन कैन फॉर्म ए ग्रुप, कैन सिट ऑन ए कंप्यूटर एंड ए लैपटॉप एंड स्टार्ट वर्किंग फ्रॉम देयर होम फॉर एनी कंपनी इन द बीपीओ सिस्टम. दैट्स हाउ वी आर सीकिंग टू चेंज द इंटायर नैरेटिव ऑफ द कंट्री. नेक्स्ट, आई एम ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. वन डे द प्राइम मिनिस्टर आस्क्ड मी, रवि तुम कहते हो हिंदुस्तान में इतनी मोबाइल लोग यूज करते हैं, बनता कितना है? देयर वर ओनली 2 मोबाइल फैक्ट्रीज इन 2014. फ्रेंड्स, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू टेल यू that India today has 127 mobile manufacturing factories in India in the last 4 years. And if you add the components, there is 268. Noida mein 57 factories hai. And the latest Samsung factory which has come is going to manufacture 1 crore mobile phone every month. India today is the second biggest mobile manufacturer after China in the world. That's how you can change. From mobile to automobile to medical electronics to LED bulbs to unconventional energy solar panels. India is emerging a lot in these fields. I wish Punjab also well for that. Next. Digital, I have already spoken about next. Digital payment. Bheem app, other UPI. India is emerging as a big center of digital payments. And I will give you one example. This started Bheem UPI in October 16. 48 crore 1.31 lakh transaction value 48 crore 2 saal pehle. Abhi hamare paas jo data hai 52.49 crore transaction 82,232 crore. Dekha aapne sirf 2 saal mein 48 crore se 82,000. और भारत के भीम यूपीआई की निशानी क्या है? अंगूठा लगाओ, पेमेंट पाओ. एक समय अंगूठा छाप क्या था मालूम है ना आपको? अंगूठा छाप मतलब जीरो. द डिजिटल वर्ल्ड हैज एम्पावर्ड द थंब, वेयर बाय द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ योर थंब यू कैन गेट सर्विसेज एंड ऑल्सो गेट योर पेमेंट. नेक्स्ट. दैट्स ऑल. Now let me conclude in another 5 minutes because I have to catch a flight for Delhi. This is the just the beginning. Yet we are doing digital scaling also in a very big way. My NILET system is doing a good job in that. My STPI is doing a good job in the BPO scheme, CSE I talked about. And then R&D initiative we are taking in the field of electronics, in the field of innovation. And one thing to my young friends, come to the startup. Next. Come to the startups. Skip that. Startups come. Yes, startups. To my young friends, India is becoming a big center of startups. Their number is 7,000 plus. India is the third biggest startup movement in the world today. And I want to tell you one example. One day, the Asian head of a big IT company came to meet me. He said, Mr. Minister, sir, I have to give you a good news. Earlier, when I used to go to big IITs, young boys and girls used to rush to me for campus recruitment, who were the toppers. But now when I go, they say, we want to become job givers and not job seekers. We want to become a startup. That's a change happening in India. And speaking in the lovely, lovely university, I have to appeal to all of you. Dil mein ek armaan rakho ki hume bhi startup shuru karna hai padhai ke baad. Create karna hai. From healthcare to education to digital delivery of services. Aaj jo hamare common service center ke bachche hai na, wo e-health mein bahut bada kaam kar rahe hai. आज गांव बैठ के लोग भैया हेलो अभी उसको बंद करो बंद करो. वो ई पेंशन का काम कर रहे हैं. आजकल मिलिट्री के लोग रिटायर्ड पेंशनर शहर नहीं जाते क्योंकि वही कॉमन सर्विस सेंटर में पेमेंट हो जाता है. दीज यंग बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स आर कमिंग विद न्यू इनोवेशन. आई अर्ज द यंग पीपल ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी इवन द साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी प्लीज स्टार्ट इनकरेजिंग देम. यू सी दिस डेटा. Today, 8 Indian startups are unicorn. What is the meaning of unicorn? 6,000 plus dollar, 6,000 crore dollar plus. That is the part, 6,000 dollar plus. You understand how it goes on? Now if in, and many of them are working for outside. Many of Indian BPOs are serving Oxford, Australia, England, America. The world is looking towards India. And therefore, I'm going to come with a data protection law very soon, which Ashok talked about. We will never compromise on data sovereignty, sensitive data. Yes, some movement is important. But India's data must be respected of Indians. Data must be available for research, innovation, but that should be anonymized data. We are equally cognizant of the privacy part, that the privacy of Indian must be respected, with one caveat. Privacy is not to be a shield for terrorists and the corrupt. And thirdly, if internet is the finest creation of human mind, it must be safe and secure. Cyber security is equally important. And therefore, we in India are also insisting, the Prime Minister himself has talked globally, that cyber war is a bloodless war. And the entire world has to come together. It is no joke, my friends. Facebook has the biggest presence in India. WhatsApp has the biggest presence in India. Twitter has the third biggest presence in India. Let me ask, how many of you are on the WhatsApp? Facebook? Good. How many of you are on Twitter? I'm very happy to hear that. All these companies are welcome to do business in India because India is a big digital market. And therefore, we are encouraging India's digital economy to become a $1 trillion economy. When I talk of digital economy, I mean communication, I mean IT, I mean e-commerce, I mean electronic manufacturing, digital delivery of services, and new technology, artificial intelligence, to Internet of Things, to blockchain. We have set up many centers of excellence in India, which are already, and you see the last slide. Best time to do science in India. 200% increase in number of returning scientists between 12 and 17. Today, Indians are returning to India and wanting to do business in India. India's ranking in Global Innovation Index jumped from 81 to 60th in 2017. India has 6th position in scientific publication and 10th in patent filing. India ranked 13th in Nature Index for high quality scientific research. Data analytical industry to grow to 16 billion by 2025. Third most attractive investment destination for technology transaction. If this is the emerging change happening in India in the last 4 years, 4.5 years, the future is bright. Abhi to ye shuruaat hai, aage aur bahut jana hai. Therefore, friends, my request to all of you is, communicate these successes. Send your views on MyGov. I am open to all the suggestions. But what is our mission? To make India the number one global power in the field of digitization. And why I am saying so? There is a mission behind all this. India may have missed the industrial revolution. Kyunki hum angrezo ke andar the. India may have missed the entrepreneur revolution because of the license permit quota raj, which happens in 1780s and 90s. India does not want to miss the digital revolution. We want to become the leaders in the digital revolution. And Digital India is a part of that. This is our mission. This is our hard work. But this is just the beginning. Let us join together in that transformation. Thank you. Namaste. Jai Hind.